let us solve the question number 33. It is again from complex analysis, and it says that f of z is equal to real z, and which of the following option is true? That is, I am writing it, f of z is equal to real z. Then they are saying that first option says that f is continuous everywhere on C. Option B says that f is differentiable. Option A says that f is discontinuous everywhere on C. Option B says that f is differentiable everywhere on C. Option C says that f is not differentiable on C. Option D says that f is analytic on C. Again, just observe the options. First option says that f is discontinuous everywhere on C. Second option says that f is differentiable everywhere on C. Third option says that f is differentiable at no point on C. And option D says that f is analytic on C. Okay. So, we have to find out the correct option, right? First of all, let us discuss about the continuity of f. Okay. So, f of z is equal to f of x plus iy, right? If, so they are saying that this is real z, so this is nothing but x, right? So first of all, if we write f of x plus iy as uxy plus ivxy, then the real part uxy will be x, and the complex part or imaginary part vxy will be 0 for all x, y, for all x, y. Now, observe that this is a constant function which is continuous, and this function is continuous everywhere. So, this u and v both are continuous everywhere. Same, I can say that this f is continuous, and hence option A is not correct, which says that f is discontinuous everywhere on C. We already observed that f is continuous everywhere on C. Now, option B says that f is differentiable everywhere on C. Option D says that f is differentiable at no point of C. Option D says that f is analytic on C. So, we know that if a function is differentiable, then it must satisfy CR equation at that point. So, if uxy is equal to ax and vxy is equal to 0, then ux is equal to 1 and vy is equal to 0. And uy is equal to 0 and vx is equal to 0. So, can I say that ux is equal to vy? No, it is not true. So, f's do not satisfy CR equation anywhere, and hence I can say that f is not differentiable, and f is differentiable at no point of C, and hence I can say that option C is our correct option, right? So, we have solved the question number 33. Now, let us solve the question number 34.